Right, what we're going to show you to make is a simple dish. It's a courgette, pea and basil soup. Really easy to make. Simply, that's what the recipe is. And this is what it should look like. Cook is called simple for one reason. It's easy. If I can do it, anyone can do it. It just consists of some basic vegetables. The courgettes here. Yes, they come pre-packed.
Yeah.
And we've got the peas. We've got one whole lemon, which we're going to zest. And of course, we need salt and pepper, preferably sea salt. And we need one whole head of garlic. And all we're going to do is prep the veg up. We're going to fry it off. We're going to add some of the greens at the end to try and keep that real vibrant green, keep the freshness of the greens. And then we're going to blitz it, and it'll be pretty much ready. It's really easy. To begin with, get a frying pan, put some oil in here. We're going to use some olive oil. Just set that to, don't put it on full heat. Olive oil doesn't like to be too heated too fast, too quickly. Just more than coat the pan. 250 grams of the peas. You can use frozen peas. It still retains the freshness, the vitamins. It's still good to use. Very convenient, especially in these times. So what I'm doing this recipe actually makes for 8, but I'm gonna do it for 4. So I'm gonna half the ingredients. So we only need 3 courgettes. We need 250 grams of frozen peas. I'm gonna stick the kettle on. See, can multitask. But do the peas first, because once you put the peas in the hot water, it defrosts, but then you can maintain and keep the water to use with the vitamins, the C vitamins and B vitamins, all the water soluble vitamins. We're looking at B and C. So just cover that. So what we're gonna do now, we're gonna chop the courgettes up. So what it says is pretty much, you chop it into 3 centimeters thick, so it's really quite thick. Remember always to curve your fingers in, and always use the edge of the knife. Basically get the blunt of the knife. I'm just gonna crunch this down. You pretty much get the cloves out really easy. It's always good having a little bit of a... Right, a really good gadget is this Joseph garlic. What it does is it removes the skin from the cloves. So basically you get your whole head here. It's probably better you do it in twos if you're going to do so many in one go. Pretty much you put them into your little basket there and you roll it up and you pretty much... You can do it in different ways. You can massage it on the side, which is good. Now if it have it all the heads declothed. What this asks is to fry these off whole. So we're just gonna put these in the frying pan now. So we've been frying the garlic. Now we're just gonna place the courgettes, the really thick slices, just face down. So you don't completely cook it through. You want to retain the goodness as well. So we're just gonna put that back. Fry that off for about 5 minutes, turn it over, and then we're going to prep up the rest of the veg. Simply just pouring all this in here. Putting the water back. Now what we need for this is we need roughly half a litre. A litre if you want to make for 8 people, we're going to make for 4. So half a litre is up to here. So I'm going to top that up with hot water. You can either buy pre-made veg stock, or you can actually make it, or you can cheat, which is what we're going to do here. You can't always use premium ingredients, especially in these times. It's good to use things up in the larder and your cupboards. So we're going to use 2 of the OXO vegetable cubes. Once you've just slightly fried off the one side of the courgettes, we need to season that. Okay, seasoning is very important with soup. So we're going to add some sea salt and plenty of pepper. And then put that back to heat. So I'm going to prepare the greens. We've got the peas, yep. And then we've got the basil. So we're just going to finely chop the basil. Just remove the main end bits and then just roughly chop up because. So what we're going to do now, we're going to zest the lemon and juice it. Right, so once the veg is fried off, just remove it. Just showing you, we normally keep it in the hob, but I just wanted to show you. So basically, we add the vegetable stock over the top. Put that back to the frying pan to simmer. Good little gadget for clean as you go is my trusty vacuum. Make sure you clean the nozzle before you use it, of course. And wine matching with this dish, I'd go with an Italian cataratto, which is quite a unique grape, not many grapes that people have heard of. It's from Sicily and it really goes well with the dish. It's got a nice citrus balance. It's got a nice richness to it, which goes very well with this dish. So, really recommend this. Right, the garnishes for this dish. We've grated some lemon zest there. So it's also nice just pick some heads off the top of the basil leaves. These are really nice little garnishes. So just put these on the side. So we just get a little plate put on the side. Feta is an essential thing to have in the fridge. It lasts a long time, but quite a versatile. This has been simmering. Put the heat proof down. What we're going to do now is we're going to add the greens on top to simmer. Allow that to simmer, and then to ladle it into the blitzer. There we go, it's added, now we're going to blitz it. So we've blitzed it, now we're going to serve it. My wife is going to be the prime taster. Taste tester. I'm going to serve this. It's always good to just wipe the side of the dish. And there we go. Just before you think you got away, storage. Great if you've got one of these sealed containers, preferably tall, but you can also use wide ones, but the sealed ones are really good. What we're going to do now is just transfer this into here. It's got a real good colour to this, really vibrant, ideal for this time of year. So we're just going to pour this into here. Oh wow, that smells fantastic, really healthy. Just give you really that colour.